spiritual labor, but not fake. She's a false god. Quit acknowledging false gods on God's days. All right, we're approaching the full moon coming up in June. Very important full moon. That will be the day of the birthday of Judah and the birthday and passing of Judah. As you know, Judah is the one that was given the leadership over the children of Israel. And we know Judah means praise. Yeah, right? And shouldn't that be cool? What's going to happen near the full moon? But topic of the message. I was talking to a person at the River Walk, and it's interesting that I do this post that, you know, love makes a difference, but lust make things difficult. And it's interesting that when I was talking to him about DNA, about we are all different, and I put it together. Oh, right there, I put it all together. Oh, we are different, that we can make a difference or make things difficult. See what I'm saying? And this was fired, this message right here. See, now, here's the thing. You know, like I tell people, the Word of God says about love. I mean, this simple commandment Jesus gave us in John 15 is that you love one another. You know what I'm saying? He's love one another. Man, why is it so difficult to love these days? Well, when you got all of a world that is influencing people to be about the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes, pride of life, it's going to be very difficult to learn to love someone and love someone to God's standards of love. As what we see, God's standards of love is a greater standards that Jesus talks about in Matthew 5:4-4, that has the power to love your enemies, bless those that curse you, pray for them that despitefully use you. That is a powerful love, and it's a powerful performance to achieve. As we know, that's not happening as much as in the world we live in, and people are not motivated to be about that ideal, to love your enemies and bless those that curse you and pray for them spitefully use you. Well, that's what the idea of what Christians are supposed to be showing, that performance to the world, and showing the performance of the world that it does work. And not only showing a performance to the world, but more importantly, showing it to your Heavenly Father in heaven. You know what I'm saying? Your Heavenly Father in heaven God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son to make a difference in this world. You know what I'm saying? Not make things difficult. Jesus Christ came to make a difference concerning that a system is come for. See, here's what's dangerous about darkness. I'm finding out, you know, looking at things in a procedure. What makes lust difficult, because it's an ideal form of darkness. And what that means is it's something that is unknown. Like, people are doing wrong things and they don't know that it's how wrong it is. You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all meet people and you see people do something negative, and you think, what's wrong with that person? Why that person did that? Why that person yelled at this person? Why this person want to fight? Why this person want to argue? Well, they don't see nothing wrong with it. You know, people that do something negative don't really see spiritually. See? They don't spiritually see nothing wrong with doing something wrong. You know what I'm saying? And that's what makes spiritual darkness, you know, powerful, because I don't see nothing wrong doing something wrong. You know what I'm saying? It's the state of darkness that people are in. That I like how 1 John talks about that idea that, you know, that I found out darkness make things difficult. See, you know, we operate in darkness. When you can't see, of course, you will have a difficult time going places. You will be running into things. You'll be tripping over things. You know what, we use that word tripping. Why are you tripping? Why are you tripping all the time? Well, people are tripping all the time because they're in darkness. You know what I'm saying? You know, and they're responding to the darkness with inside their hearts. That, like, I, you know, the ideal of darkness, if you go in a house, you know what I'm saying, with darkness and you can't see, you're going to find yourself tripping over something, hitting something, breaking something that could be valuable to you, you know, damaging yourself, you know what I'm saying, hurting yourself because you in darkness and you having a difficult time trying to understand where you're at. Ooh, let me say that again. You have a difficult time understanding where you at, and that's what the condition of sin does to people. They have a difficult, they're doing something wrong, and they know it's wrong, but they don't understand that it's wrong. That's what's wrong with a person in sin. They don't understand to what extent the wrong that they're doing is affecting what they're affecting themselves, infecting everybody else. You know what I'm saying? And we like, what's wrong with you? What, you know, we like to talk, unfortunately, bad about people and their actions that do come repeatedly do negative actions. And we like, what's wrong with a person? What's wrong? No. Well, that is the power of pretty much spiritual darkness. It's all about making things difficult because you have a desire, something that is going to pretty much bring destruction to you. You know what I'm saying? The wages of sin is death. You know what I'm saying? And the thing is, you know, we need to understand that that's what lust is, a form of act that leads you into darkness, that you can't see things. And when you can't see things, it will be difficult to do things, to difficult to cultivate relationships, difficult to try to accomplish and achieve something in life. That's why people are difficult. That's why people are frustrated, mad at certain things that they cannot accomplish within their own ability. That's the problem. And, you know, I was, you know, and it's all about I, you know what I'm saying? I need to accomplish something in this life and I need to do it within my own ability, but I'm going to fail because I don't realize that I'm in a position of darkness, that, you know, that I'm going to have a difficult time of accomplishing something. Now I got the difficult thing talked about. I hope y'all understand that, you know. But now, making a difference. Now, Jesus Christ, of course, his example was there to make a difference. And make a difference. He was, you know, of course, Matthew 5, talking about, you know, the kingdom of heaven. He was about giving the solutions to the people in the Sermon on the Mount concerning the kingdom of heaven, that when you operate in this kingdom, you will make a difference in this world. But you will make a difference in the world. But here's the thing I do want to talk about, that everybody's different, that people need to understand. Everybody has their different strengths and their different weaknesses. That's what needs to come when we learn to be honest about ourselves. We have to be honest about our strengths and weaknesses. I was talking to somebody at Starbucks, and I was trying to explain to them that we need to be honest about our weakness to know that we need strength. You know what I'm saying? To know that we need to learn the ability to accomplish something. That's what the ideal of making a difference starts. When we understand that we need an ability to accomplish something, that will, but as much as we learn that, as much as we have a desire to learn how to accomplish it, because it will be difficult, it could be difficult of us learning how to make a difference. But when we realize we need to make a difference, that we will have a desire to learn, as the Word of God, to accomplish the something that can make a difference, that people will see. Because here's the thing, like I tell people about, you know, racism, you know, is a really a foolish perspective of looking at trying to resolve something based upon a color of the skin. You know what I'm saying? And I mean, it's foolish. Now you say, oh, what, Mac? It's not fool. Well, here's the thing. Once you understand that there's good, like, you know, I learned there's good black people, there's good white people. There's good black people, there's bad black people. I mean, well, to me, there's black people that do good, and there's black people that do bad. There's white people that do good, there's white people that do bad. There's Mexicans that do good, and there's Mexicans that do bad. There's Chinese people that do good, there's Chinese people that do bad. That is a fact. And to make a big deal about a color is concerning to races is defeating the purpose when everybody's struggling with something negative inside you. You know what I'm saying? Concerning the different makeup that they are from, concerning their mother and father, they've been inherit something that they're trying to figure out what's inside of them and to what extent of what is inside of them that can help them say, oh, this is the weakness, then I need to learn how to better myself within this area so I can do something that can make a difference. You know what I'm saying? Instead of hurt people, I can be about helping people. You know what I'm saying? As we know, when people are difficult, they end up hurting people than they do helping people. You know what I'm saying? And the thing is, making a difference, the only best way, of course, is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ can reveal who you are and show you your weaknesses and show you the strengths. And like I keep teaching a message about, let the weak say I'm strong. You're going to say you're strong because you have identified your weakness, and you're going to be strong because you allow Jesus Christ to strengthen the area of your weaknesses, that you can have the ability to make a difference in how you speak to people, what you do to people, how you can do more and more. But when you recognize that you have a weakness, you will want to do more to not yield to the weak condition inside you. You know what I'm saying? That Paul talks about the thorn in the flesh. That we don't want the thorn in the flesh hinder us to try to make a difference to help other people everywhere that needs help, is what the ideal of people that making a difference is supposed to be driven to perform. It's all about, is you got to be driven to perform to make a difference, especially in the world we live in that's too much people operating the lust of the flesh, making things difficult to how to get along with one another, love one another pretty much. You're going to have to see that you need to make more a difference, and you're going to need more strength. And that's why you're going to need Jesus Christ to perform that, bless those that curse you, pray for them that spitefully use you. Oh, love your enemies, sorry. And bless those that curse you, pray for them that spitefully use you. You need the power of heaven to accomplish that performance that can make a difference in your life. But you got to understand that you're different from other people, and you need to talk to people and conversate with people like they're different. They're not you. You know what I'm saying? People are not you. You know what I'm saying? I see people try to talk to people and they're like, why you can't do this right? I know how to do this right. Why you can't do this right? You know what I'm saying? No, that person's not you. You know what I'm saying? You need to understand that this person is different. You know what I'm saying? That you need to communicate and ask, what's going on with it? What's your problem? What's the situation? Oh, I had that problem. Oh, yes, I struggle, but I learned that I need Jesus Christ to perform better in the areas of my life. It's how it's supposed to be, the dialogue of having conversations with people is about. Not, you know, oh, you need to just know how to be, you know, like me, because I know how to do this right. You need to do this right like I do this right. You know, I know those kind of people. All right, that's the message. Hope you got it. Hope you understand it. Hope he blesses. God be the glory to him forever and ever. In Jesus' name, amen.